forged in new dimensions of thinking and moving, the Celestials saw my true potential and pulled out a seat for me at their table. As I witnessed the world above, I learned that our home was in fact a mobile fortress, traveling across the cosmos and not stationary like I had been. I soon learned that my masters were conquerors of the Outer Black, moving from world to world, adopting them into our faction by force. While the warriors stormed the planetoids, I continued to direct the attacks from the ship. Ever since the day they granted me this new chassis, I have never failed to guide the Celestials into victory. With every triumph I gave them, their concepts of defeat became a distant memory. Here carved in cosmic shade rock, a statue in honor of Master Garrok. Alright. Finds asteroids via AI operations. Thank you. gotta... Oh, bugger! I really hate you. You're Ragnar, you're supposed to be weak as shit. Not shield guys, screw. How can you make an annoying fight any more annoying? machine engineer or something. Finally! Holy crap!
You win.
Like, I died 4 times on this guy. Ammo plus health. Later, my masters and I came upon a remote planet made completely of an unknown mineral and devoid of organic life. Prior to our arrival, I sent out expedition drones to investigate the surface of the planetoid. What I found deeply concerned me over the safety of our people. There may not have been an organic life on that world, but there was aggressive life nonetheless. I warned the Celestials that their power was no match for the nature of the life of the planetoid. There was no logical chance that their assault would be victorious, but the Celestials had become intoxicated from their countless victories using me. Their vision became so obscured that they demanded my despairing calculations to be but a glitch. It was the planet of evil, made up of all negative matter. Who do I want? I don't know. This is... dun dun dun! My master uses the old laboratories to study this biggest sample of Garrok. Is there any way of getting up there? Can I, like, climb up there? Just kind of shoot the boss from up there? That last fight took a lot of lives out of me. Proto vampire. God, it's a big old green bear. Can I stun him? saved. Saved. New life. Second chance. I did get the first hive. Two lives. Oh God. Before the first moon was able to hide behind the planet, the Celestials were force-fed the taste of extinction, and me, the one that warmed them, was all that remained. I departed the planet with a ship and some samples of the planet's minerals I named Shaderock. Alone aboard the ancient vessel, I studied the ethereal powers behind the Shaderock, discovering mind-shattering answers to questions all self-aware life would ask themselves, from the beginning of the universe to the worlds after death. I carved my throne from this material as a reward for taking the path of logic and reason. As for my old masters, I decorated the halls and chambers with their bones and monuments as a reminder of their fatal flaw. Oh, cool. Alright. Ah, boy. Back when they called the shots, the Celestials used this cord to test their might. That's cool. That's lucky that I found that. I jump up here.
Can you hear them?
Oh God. already getting my butt kicked. Oh, wow.
Try again.
That's not a very good start. Thank you. just got a power. Got hit by a ship's altar. No! Okay, armor. Hell. Okay, took care of that. Oh god. More armor. Oh god. Get away from me. Healed. Holy crap, I need more armor. Oh no! These guys are getting close. I need armor. Oh man. Okay, I can get armor off this guy. Maybe. This guy. No! I killed him! No! Okay, this guy, give me armor. Yes, armor. Oh my god. No, go away! Too soon! No, don't hit me with power shots. Oh my god, I gotta go back to this hell. Still at 25% health? Yeah. Okay, there's... Yes, I got armor from him! Oh my god. No! Oh god. No!
Try again.